for parallel and distributed systems. We have reached meeting 6. This is about remote invocation, and in the third video we will discuss about HTTP. Let's start our video. So in the last video we have discussed about remote invocation and client server, and now we are going to discuss an application that uses a client server. If you hear about client server, you must be familiar with the term. Client server is the basic of any type of communication in computer networks, and the main thing that you use computer networks is usually for web server. So web server or web service is an application of client server, and usually you use a web service for, of course, in your daily life you use a web service for your web browser. Know that this web service and web browser uses a protocol, a well-known protocol called HTTP. It stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So Hypertext Transfer Protocol is example of client server or remote invocation in general. In this video, we are going to discuss more about HTTP. So, just like we discussed before, HTTP protocol consists of a client and a server. And in the client is usually the web browser, and the server is the web service. And just like the client and server, there is a request. This is the request from the client to the server, and this is the reply. The request is called HTTP request, and the reply is called HTTP response. So now we are going to discuss about HTTP request first. So in your browsing activity, usually when do you use your HTTP request? Is when you send something to the server. And what do you send something to the server? When you click a link, you are sending one type of HTTP request method. There are several methods, but the main methods are usually GET and POST. As you can imagine, GET means that you are requesting something from the server, and on the other hand, POST is some activity that means you want to send something from your computer to the server, and there are many other methods. Here you can see there is head and put and delete and others. And in the HTTP response, usually you get an answer. And besides an answer, you usually get something called the HTTP status code. Status code is the status of your answer. The answer that usually that you want is 200 or 2 something. 2 something indicates success. So this is the response that you hope for. 200 means okay. So when your browser, when you click something, and after you click something, there is a new page. that means that status is okay. And if it is not okay, usually it is either for something or five something. The difference between for something and five something is for something is for client error and five something is for server error. The most famous error that you know is usually 404, which means that the link that you are searching for it doesn't exist or is not found. So that is the end of the first video about HTTP. In the next video, we will continue the next.